One by one, let me ask that question first to Ashok Pandit. Is it not correct that a large part of the reason why Salman Khan went to Ahmedabad, as he said so in our interview, and I know that you saw it, was to seek tax relief for Jai Ho? That's the reason he says he went to Ahmedabad. No, so there's a commercial reason behind that photo opportunity with Modi. That's what Dr. Rahmani and others are arguing. Ashok Pandit.
Rahul, tell me one thing. It's so great of him that he's going for promoting of a film and is concerned about something important, issues of the nation. What is the problem? And then Mr. Rahmani is talking about...
This is what Salman himself said.
Allow him to complete his argument.
Let me finish. A politician cannot teach at least anybody else as far as commercial deals are concerned. They have no right because commercial deals are maximum done by politicians. So they are ready to sell the country also. So that is not, let politicians not, you know, give lectures on commercialization of a product. It's nice of Salman Khan when he's going to promote a film and you ask him a question and he straightforward comes up with his opinion. He's a nationalist. He's an Indian. So what is wrong if he says this?
Kamal Faruqi, would you not concede at least this much, that the ferocity with which questions are asked of Modi, the same ferocity is not visible when it comes to chief ministers in other states? You know, there were riots in Assam, massive riots. There were riots in Uttar Pradesh. There were riots in Maharashtra. Yet nobody jumps up and down in the manner in which people target Modi. Is that not fair, Kamal Faruqi?
You have asked a very pertinent question and I am agreeing with you, but please understand, as far as Muzaffarnagar is concerned, Muslims were supposed to be the supporting Samajwadi Party whole hog. Now you will see what is the reaction, and everywhere Mr. Akhilesh Singh government has been so much blamed. Everybody is blaming him that he has mishandled it, rather he has played into the galleries. In fact, number one, number two, the basic, in fact we have digressed the whole thing. Three Khans are supporting three different political parties. Why are we bringing their religion into it? They are the actor, they are the film people, they are supporting Mr. Khan, one Khan is supporting Mr. Modi, fine. Why should you be seen as a Muslim icon? If the other Khan is supporting Congress, the other party is supporting somebody else. Mr. Amitabh Bachchan also supported Gujarat, led by Mr. Modi. So please don't bring the religion into it. I agree with Suresh Wala what he has said. Why is being seen as a Muslim icon? He's got his own independent authority. He has got the full right in the country to support or not to support anybody.
No, but why as Mr. Suresh Wala says, the reality in India is that each time someone has spoken up in favor of Modi from the Muslim community, whether it is Ghulam Vastanvi, whether it is Mehmood Madni in the interview he did with us on Seedhi Baat, there's an immediate attack against them. You know, Kamal Faruqi and Dr. Rahmani can deny it, Mr. Suresh Wala, but the people aren't entitled to come up with their opinion. No one is burning effigies of Amitabh Bachchan or Ajay Devgan for supporting Modi. They're burning effigies of Salman Khan for taking the stand, Mr. Suresh Wala.
Think that he's a Muslim icon.
Yes. In fact, I want to ask Kamal Faruqi sahab and Dr. Rahmani, have we done any wrong in engaging with Mr. Modi? We live in Gujarat. There are 75 lakhs Muslims of Gujarat. If they have any problem, should they go to Shivraj Chauhan? Or should they go to Dr. Manmohan Singh?
Dr. Rahmani,
answer
Modi, that question.
What crime have I done?
Are you okay with Salman Khan endorsing Mr. Modi? Or do you have a problem with that? Answer that question.
It's not a question of Salman Khan alone.
No, answer you, just this question.
As far as the communal rights are concerned,
answer this question. Are you okay with Salman Khan throwing his weight behind Narendra Modi? Answer my question.
Yes, I'm answering. We equate Narendra Modi, Tarun Gogoi, Shivraj Chauhan, whosoever, whether they belong to the Congress or is Akhilesh Yadav or is Narendra Modi, whosoever is sponsoring and patronizing communal right in the country, we are against them equally. Whether he is Narendra Modi or he is Akhilesh Yadav.
Okay, I want to now, in the concluding part, ask all my panelists, and I'll start with Madhu Kishwa, on whether Salman Khan taking the position that he's taken as an Indian icon, let alone whether he's a Muslim icon or a Hindu icon, I believe he's a pan-India icon. Given the fact that he's taken the position, and he said in this interview that if my going to Ahmedabad brings Hindus and Muslims closer together, then why not? Do you think with him taking the position that he's taken on riots on Modi, it will actually bring Hindus and Muslims in Gujarat and elsewhere closer together, Madhu Kishwa?
See, firstly, Rahul, I think the media needs to get its fact right. and not allow the same old lies to be repeated. They were calling it a pogrom. Pogrom means one-way killings, where one community kills the other and that's the end of the matter. Gujarat 2002 were riots. They started with Godhra, one-sided attack from Muslims on Hindus, trains are burned, then there's retaliatory violence. More Hindus died in police firing. Army is called. These are established now by the SIT, monitored by the Supreme Court. These facts have gone
only
through
one community people, 7,000 people
minute
were killed.
Evaluation.
Where?
For God's sake,
in Gujarat,
Gujarat.
That's not true.
It.
There were lots of Hindus
stop
who died
lying
as well.
About it.
Hundreds of Hindus died as well, Dr. Rehmani.
Yeah.
Your facts
it,
are
it,
all wrong.
It was only go the, in the train.
Even
not,
after
not
that,
no,
even after that
lying.
In the riots, there were many Hindus
lying.
Who died. That's not correct. You're wrong factually, Dr. Rehmani.
More Hindus died. Hindus died in retaliatory violence by Muslims. Please do not lie anymore. This was a... Secondly, this is the first time the army is called within 20 hours.
Okay.
And the army is deployed...
Then what happened?
Deployed.
For 1 month...
I want to now put
month,
that question.
For 1 month, the riot was continued. Even if the army was called.
Please,
so what?
I've
no, you are factually wrong. Dr. Rehmani, the riots only continued for 3 days.
No. Because of Zafar Saleeswala here.
No, Rehmani, I mean, I'm from Ahmedabad. What are you talking?
I am
the biggest victim of the riot.
Okay, I can't have everyone speaking at the same time. Please listen to my commands. I now want to put that same question to Kamal Farooqi. Does Salman Khan taking the position that he's taken bring Hindus and Muslims closer together on the question of Modi, Kamal Farooqi?
Good wish. All the best to him if he's thinking in that direction. But please, treat him only as an actor. Don't treat him as a Muslim icon. He has got all the rights in the world to support or not to support, work for a social cause or not to work for a social cause. Let him be treated as a film icon only.
Mr. Sareshwala.
Not a Muslim icon.